Hi Steve, thanks very much for contacting us at How to Repair. We got your email the other day and I spoke to you on the phone this morning with regards to this John Lewis tumble dryer that you've got an E60 error code. Now, I've done some research on the machine for you and I thought I'd put this video together for you to assist you in repairing your machine. John Lewis is a superstore manufacturer which has their tumble dryers predominantly made for them by the Electrolux group, and that's AEG, Zanussi and Electrolux. So this dryer is actually a Zanussi dryer. Now, you've said you've got a problem with the heating system. So let's quickly just have a look at the heater before I go into the exploded diagram. You want to be doing a test on the heater. Now, these heaters can fail, usually down to the way the tumble dryer is being used or old age. They have two thermostats on the back of the heater. One is a TOC thermostat, which is a cutout thermostat. This thermostat is designed to cut out if the machine exceeds 160 degrees in temperature. The other thermostat is what you call a cycling thermostat. This means that if the thermostat gets to 90 degrees, which I think this is set at, it will cut the heating system out. And when it goes below 90 degrees, it will come back on and basically cycle the air going through the machine. This is also checked with an Ntc sensor. Now the Ntc sensor, sorry one second, let me get to the right picture. The Ntc sensor is normally down by the motor on the ducting system. Now this works on Ohm's law's resistance values, and the computer board or the circuit board knows the value of the resistance it should have at a preset temperature, and therefore calculates as the resistance drops or changes what temperature the machine is at. When we'll go through this in the workshop manual in a second. So let's just flick off that and go to the workshop manual. Now, as you can see, this machine is manufactured by Zanussi, and I'll quickly scroll through the workshop manual for you. And first thing, we've got the circuit board here, and you can actually see a relay on the circuit board. I'll just point that out with a marker for you. Basically, that circuit board, the relay sends the power down to the heating element, and that comes on and off as required, and the information from the Ntc sensor gives the circuit board that information. Now what I'm looking for here, this is the airflow circuit going through the dryer. The air gets heated up over the heater as it's drawn into the machine. It then goes through the clothes and is expelled out the bottom. And this basically expels all the moist air out of the machine. It's pretty much the same on all vented tumble dryers. Now, if we trying to find the, here we go. Here is the heater unit. And as I said, looking from where the wiring goes in on the left-hand side, the cutout thermostat, which is the TH1 safety thermostat, which is number two that you can see in the diagram here. So that is preset at, where is it? At 90 degrees, sorry, at 160 degrees. So that thermostat, if it ever exceeds 160 degrees, this will cut out and stay cut out. On some of the older type thermostats, there was a little pinhole in the back of a thermostat and you were able to reset them. But on a lot of modern ones now, you're not able to, and you'll need to replace the stat. And sometimes the manufacturers don't sell the stat separately. They only sell the complete heating unit. Okay, moving down now to the Ntc sensor. And as you can see, the sensor, I said, was at the right-hand side of the machine, and it should be down by the motor area. Now, you're able to check the values of the Ntc sensor at room temperature. At 20 degrees, it's rated at 6,000. The maximum resistance you should be getting is somewhere in the region of 6,335, and the minimum is 5,765. But this is the actual temperature at the Ntc sensor. And then, of course, it gives you the higher values as well. But you'll be able to check this, and there is a video at the website to assist you in that. Now, rolling down, we'll get to the wiring diagram. Now, I'm a little bit suspect about this because normally on the earlier models of the Zanussi machines, it used to be one relay controlling the heater. Looking at this, number four is the heater, and it looks like we have RL1 and RL2. RL1 controls the 1400 watt side of the heater, and RL2 controls the 1000 watt or 600 watt. So it might be two relays that are on the machine, and this could be the reason why you have a lower amperage relay. Normally they're about 16 amp, but I suspect that these relays could be somewhere in the region of 10 amp if it's only having to control 1400 watt. But anyway, going from that, we'll just scroll down. There is a demo mode on the machine, and also there is a diagnostic program built into these programs as well. So I'll slowly scroll through this so you can see it, and you'll be able to press pause on the video at any point. So I'll just quickly scroll through these, and then it tells you what each function will do on the actual diagnostic mode. So if you set it to number one, you've got what it should be doing here. You will need to have some sort of meter to understand if the heater is cutting in and cutting out, because when you set it to number five, you should be seeing 1400 watt being drawn. Anyway, flick through this for you, because I want to get onto the, what page are we looking for, 34. Now, here are the error codes. Now, you said you had error code 60, and as you can see here on the workshop manual, they don't actually show error code 60. Error code 60 is meaning it could be any one of these error codes, 61, 62, 63, or it is telling you there is a general fault with the heating system. So just really you want to check the whole heating system on the tumble dryer, and also check the relays as well. Now, as I said, there is a video on the relays. I'm just going to scroll through the rest of the manual for you and try and stop it where I need to so other people can see. But on the relays, you can actually take the relays off and bench test the relays under load if you wanted to. And there is a video on the website to show you that. But the workshop manuals do really assist you in actually stripping the machine down and everything else. I think the Ntc sensor is there, if I remember correctly. And that shows you also the notorious spring that flies off the motor, and people say they can't tension the belt correctly. Anyway, let's flick over to the relays and turn this off a second. Let me just finish scrolling through, just in case that's the last page. Now, if we have a look at the relays, the relay normally has 12 volt DC, and this relay that's the common one on the Zanussi is 16 amps. And you'll notice you can see three pins here. The other side, to test it, you want to desolder it from the board. And the other side of the relay has the six pins that you need to desolder. So you'll have to work out how that actually works when you've got it off the board, and watch the video on how to test Ntc relays. I hope you found this helpful, Steve. Thanks very much for watching it. And if you need any further help, just give us a bell. Thanks a lot.